Well, 10 days from the graft, here we go. This is the moment of truth. We're going to find out how the ladies got on. Now, of course, you might be wondering why 10 days is the crucial moment, because if you happen to have got a little bit older grub and one of your queens hatches out, she is not going to be very impressed and she's going to kill all the rest of the queens that are in your blooming queen-raising box. So it's rather imperative. You don't want to be too early and you don't want to be too late. It's a bit like a lot of things in life. Now, being that I haven't actually got a jolly incubator, is it called an incubator when they keep shit warming? When they incubate eggs and stuff, you can get one of them to carry yourselves. Here at the Bush Bee Farm, we haven't actually got one yet because I tried to buy one and they didn't want to sell it to me. So we haven't actually got an incubator. So what we're going to do is use this little box. I'm going to shake some ladies in there to keep ourselves nice and cozy while we go travelling. Not that we've got to travel too far, so they should be fine, but still, this is not a bad option, especially if you've got to go for a bit of a drive to where the breeding stock are. Rightio, chicks, what have we done? Of course, this queen rearing gig is a bit like everything else we do in beekeeping. We try to implement what the bees would do naturally, but then the bees just get to decide how much they want to do. So, anyway, let's have a look, shall we, folks? I don't know if we can do this, but maybe we need a drum roll. I should have two sticks, but anyway, I'm flat out lucky just finding one hive tool, never mind two of them. And then we're just going to give them a little bit of a puff under the lid. Here we go, the great reveal. Hello, ladies. Good morning. It's a fine morning here in the Riverland. We'll pop your little feeder out because you don't need that anymore. Where are we going to put that? We'll get that out of the way. Good girls. You wouldn't believe how much they can eat. Tell you what. All their little tummies. Yeah, we're just going to open this up. Make ourselves a little gap. Now, we've got our queen cells over here. It's easy to tell which one's your hanger because it's a different design. It's got some nails across the top. Let's, don't sting me. Oh, crikey, you girls are being busy. Hang on. I'll just shake some of the workers in here and then we'll show you. Now, don't get excited if you come out to your queen cells and they've got carried away. They've made a little bit too much wax here because they've jolly well got too good a life going on. But don't freak yourself out, that's no big drama. What you need is a sharp little Stanley knife and you have to trim some of this off when you put it in the little brood boxes. But what you really want them to look like is this bit here. This is what they're supposed to look like. And then we just want to pop this in our carry box with our little nurse bees can do some work for us. You might just shake in another little bit of beekeeping excitement. So some of them will stay behind, maybe if we're lucky. You don't need too many. Just have a quick look to make sure you haven't got any cells that they've decided to raise. Right, we've finished with this one as far as a queen rearer goes. Some of them will stay in there and look after ourselves, which will be good. Now we're basically finished with our cell raiser. You can spend a whole lot of effort if you're doing this like just for yourself, like we are. It's not that stressful. You don't have to bloody get all carried away. You just get her queen right again. So put her back the way she was before you got here and upset everybody. And then they can happily go about their life. When you want them to raise you some more cells, you can just put them back together. It's pretty cool, actually. And it's interesting that some bees are better at raising queen cells than others. These girls are not actually the genetics we want. They're a little bit toey, but hell, they're doing for raising queens. So they get to live another day, even if they are a bit angry. If you happen to be doing this like we are a little bit more, don't use this bloody super without a handle. It's a pain in the bum. Now, it's very awkward to lift up with no handle. Rightio. Yeah. So here's our divider board. The girls are all orientated to there. Now we're going to take that off. Shake our little ladies downstairs. Little workforce they are. Two options you can go with. I normally turn it back around again just so as that when I come back and I want to use it again, it's just the same routine. You could just leave it here and put it back together and they'll all figure itself out, but it's not ideal because they seem busier at the front. Right, so we're just going to twist her around. Sorry, chicks.
Cool.
Now we'll pop our top back on. Arrgh. Now, if you wanted to, you could put all your brood back in your bottom box, but it doesn't hurt to give them some new frames anyway. And they'll raise all that, they'll rear all that nice young stuff upstairs. They'll all fly out. The queen will lay some new stuff, and you'll have new frames in your bottom box. And heck, there you go. Cell raising 101. You'll find a hive mat in a minute. Now, for the fun part, we're going to go and put them in some little hives to see if we can rear some queens. Ha ha! Here we are at the little yard. Now, this isn't exactly how you should set up your queen breeding little layout, but this is where we ended up. Now, these hives here, we've actually brought back from the apiary, and we've just got a frame of brood and some spare bees. And so we're just going to pop our head in here and make sure these girls haven't decided to raise their own queen cell. And then we're going to put one of our ripe queen cells in the box. And then in a couple of days, she'll hatch out and run around and get all happy. One thing to remember, these are only a very small little colony, only a couple of frames of bees, just when you do that, make sure they've got enough food. So we've given them a frame of honey, so they've got plenty of extras to eat. Because you've got to remember that when the queen hatches, she's not going to go out and fly out and do her thing straight away, and the girls that are in here have to actually feed her. So they're going to be raising some young that are on the brood frames, and they're also going to be wanting to feed the queen. So they want some honey and some pollen in this box with them to save all that effort, so the queen doesn't, you know, so she's, I guess, fit and healthy when she goes out for her mating flights. So if you weren't confused before, you probably are now. Right, okay. So now we just want to pop the lid off. We'll give a little bit of smoke in the doorway. Pop our little lid off. Have a look what's going on. Hello, ladies, what's happening? I said, hello, Mr. Bush Beeman, we haven't seen you for a whole week. Something like that anyway. It'd be interesting if they could actually talk to us. It would be like Dr. Doolittle of the bees. There's our nice frame of honey that they're enjoying. And here's the frame of brood that we threw in there, which they're filling full of honey as well, which is cool. So they've gone out and collected some stuff because they've got nothing else to do. We're just having a bit of a quick look to make sure they haven't decided to make a cell of their own. I try not to give them too much young stuff. Looks like there's a little queen cell down here, but I don't think it's actually anything in it. But we'll probably get rid of it anyway because you don't really want them raising their own queen, because otherwise the genetics that you're trying to create, well, it'll be their genetics and not the one you pop in. They're looking pretty happy. So now we need to get a queen cell and we need to put that on the brood frame. So they got the beginning of a little queen cell here that we're going to knock down, just so as there was nobody home in that anyway, so that's all good. Now we want to make a little ditch somewhere near where the brood is and pop our queen cell in. So I'm going to turn it around so it faces me, because you've got to have the queen cell dangling downwards, of course. Right, yeah, we'll get a queen cell out of our little box. Mm-hmm. Ooh. Now these little girls will figure out where they are in a minute. See how they're keeping the cells nice and looked after? Now the easy part here is you just pick the queen cell that you're going to pop off, and you basically just break it off at the plastic part. You just want to pop it off. Oh, Lord. One would hope there's a happy little queen in there somewhere. Cool. So now what we've got to do is make a little ditch for our cell to fit in. I like to put it somewhere around where the other brood is, so then the girls will sort of congregate there. All right, just make a little ditch like this. Make sure the queen cell's got somewhere to be. And then we just push it in with the... So you use the back part, the plastic coney bit, which should hold it in pretty good. Don't damage the front, because that's where your boss is living. You don't want to wreck her after all this effort. Then I like to just hold it up, make sure she's not going to fall off if you give it a little rattle. And you want to turn it so as that she's facing in. Got plenty of room to move. Push her up against the other frame. Push your honey frame across. Slip your extra frame in. And then, in another day or so, she should pop out of that little pot, out of her little cell, and go, "Hi, I'm your new boss." And then the ladies will be all happy because they'll actually have a new leader, which is what they need. they'll wake up in a couple of days and they'll have the boss that they need to start making new babies. And they'll be making the babies that we want them to. So how cool is that? It's pretty clever, isn't it? I think we're trying to work with the ladies to give the outcome that we want and that they want. So everybody wins. It's a win-win-win. Now, this is a little bit of a double box that I made up because we didn't have enough newt boxes when we were down. So, it's probably better if you have all newt boxes, but if you haven't got enough newt boxes, you can have a crack at this. Because all I did, I had some bases that actually had two entrances. I thought I'd have an entrance this side and this side. So I've got two halves in here. So basically I've got two newt boxes in this big box and I've cut this hive mat to be exactly the perfect size to fit inside the lid so the queen can't run up and interact with each other. So we've got, do you want to see the divider board I made? Here's my thingy-me-jeeby. What to do with that? There it is. Should get the magnet in my pocket. So my idea was we've got one lot of bees this side, one lot of bees this side. Then of course you have to keep them apart. So I was in the workshop and I thought, well, she would be a pretty bloody clever bee if she could walk through that jolly plastic foundation. So I just put the plastic foundation and I sealed it on and I put a little bit extra board across here so that it would be nice snug fit to the edge of the box. And I got a little bit of extra padding at the bottom just for safety's sake. And that's me divider board. Bloke could have at least nailed it in a straight line, but you know, let's not get carried away. Maybe this was an early prototype. Anyway, that's to keep the girls separate. I decided that was all fairly effective, so I'm thinking I'm going to make a few more of them, and I'm actually making them from scratch. So these were bases that I already had. So we thought we might as well show you how to make yourself a double blooming newt box out of a big box. So come along, keep an eye on the station because you never know when it's going to pop up. Right, let's have a bit of a look. Now these girls haven't been here very long. We came back from, when did we get back here? Tuesday this week. But they've already started to make, this is what you don't want to have. All these queen cells that the ladies have managed to raise. Well, they're going to be the bloodline that's actually in here from these boxes, which is not necessarily what we want. We want a pure bloodline of the girls that we're trying to breed. So you want to knock down these cells. Make sure you don't end up with a queen that you don't want. Sorry, boss woman. They're not going to be pleased with us, John. They're doing a really good job. She's only just a larvae at this stage. Now, the little girls have got a little bit enthusiastic and made a bit too much stuff. So we'll just break this one off here. We're just going to break that one off. Because if you pop that queen cell in your box like that, she's probably going to have a bit of a struggle to find a way out. I don't know. I've never actually stuck her in there like that. You can see where the queen end is, so she'd probably be okay because they haven't blocked it in completely. So I just figure we'll just cut this bit of extra stuff off. The first time I found this, I freaked myself out and I thought, they must have actually not been any good. But then if you're not careful and you break it apart, you find out you've got a boss in there. And then that's a bit of a lost cause. I'll just trim her up a bit. Pop her in our hole. Make sure she's not going to fall off. And then we got to put on that music that goes little, 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 and we'll make it all happen. Come back in a couple of days' time and see whether the little ladies made it out alive. Hopefully it's all successful. Otherwise, I'll be in all sorts of trouble with the grafting team. Cool. Well, here we are a couple of days later. We thought we'd come out and we'd see how many queen cells have decided to make their way into the world and become the ruler of their own little kingdom. Now we'll have a poke in here and look at number 36. These girls aren't overpopulated because we did a bit of bee shaking from when we were out in the apiary. Some boxes got more bees than others, but then some of the bees, when we brought them back here, decided to just do their own thing and make up their own minds. And there's an empty queen cell. So she's made her way out, which is good. And I don't know whether we'll find her in here or not, but you never know. Stranger things have happened. and they're bringing in a bit of nectar, which is a good thing. So they're finding something to do with themselves. The worker bees are out working. The lady bees are all doing their thing, ripening up the honey. The boss girl lady, I don't know where she's hiding, but she's probably thinking, there doesn't want to get seen just yet. So now what'll happen is that little queen who's hatched out, the ladies in the box here, they'll give her some food and get her organised and keep her company. And then eventually she'll come out of the box and she'll take a little flight around the yard here. And then she'll fly a little bit further and a little bit further. And eventually she gets all excited and flies off and finds some drones to mate with. And woof! And then hopefully she makes it back and doesn't get eaten by a dragonfly. Otherwise that sucks. There's a fair bit of risk involved when you're a bee.